Lord, have mercy. glory of God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. Look upon us, O God, Creator and Ruler of all things, and that we may feel the working of your mercy. Grant that we may serve you with all our heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, God forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord is kind and merciful. and sisters, none of us lives for oneself, and no one dies for oneself. For if we live, we live for the Lord, and if we die for the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. For this is why Christ died and came to life, that he might be Lord of both the dead and the living. The word of the Lord.
So-and-so agree with me. Well, how would they know
give the details. And let's face it, usually when something spreads, if it isn't colorful enough, we tend to kick it up a notch or two. Again, whether or not that applies to you will depend on how courageous you're willing to be in hearing this message. Could anyone nourish anger against another and expect healing from the Lord? That question always lingers with me. None of us lives for oneself, no one dies for oneself, in life and in death with the Lord. That's why he died and rose again. If God was not meeting us with mercy when we sin and offend, it wouldn't just be a relationship that's cut off, like what happens when we don't show mercy. It would be life. That's why Christ took sin and death upon himself. And from the asking of forgiveness, the work of mercy brings fullness of life. Now, we sometimes might argue that so-and-so did something very hurtful, and they've never asked for forgiveness. Well, you're right. Jesus did not go around in his public ministry people who were steeped in sin and say, oh, by the way, when you're done this sin, I forgive you. No. But the moment there was the slightest inclination, the moment he could take advantage of a positive situation, he embraced it. And from the cross, he ultimately said, Father, forgive them. They know not what they do. Do we have the courage to say, maybe so-and-so doesn't quite know how deeply what they did affected or hurt me? Or maybe, perhaps, there's more to it than the surface. More unfortunately, sometimes some grudges are so old we can't remember the details, which in itself is the perfect reason to let it go. And the gospel finally brings it home. For the asking, we can be forgiven. Now, we can't come to confession, list off sinful behavior, and walk out, having quickly made a sign of the cross while the priest gave us absolution, and we're done. No. For our sins to be taken away, there has to be contrition. We gotta be sorry. We can't just not care less. So contrition. Then confession. That means putting into words, admitting it. With that comes absolution. The Lord's response to us. Totality of forgiveness. And then we go forth with reparation. A desire to try to repair or to move in the other direction. And now many of you know my advice. Often confession is not just a strong arm vice, but to move more toward virtue. It's easier to fight lust when we're looking for opportunities to be tender and loving, romantic, and thoughtful, and gentle. So we strive after the opposite. It's easier not to gossip and put down when we look for opportunities to compliment someone, to thank them, to look at the person who's frustrated at the cashier station, give them a smile and say, how many hours you got left? Hopefully, hope it'll go quickly. You see, when we come to terms with our own need for mercy, then we set ourselves on the path to grow in virtue. When we extend mercy to others, then we are on a path of virtue as well. For the Lord has said it very clearly. The measure you measure out will be measured back to you. The Lord has said very clearly, as you have shown mercy, so you will be shown mercy. And lest you forget, each time we pray the Our Father, a few weeks ago we looked at the creed in Mass last week, that the media, the politicians, the public opinion doesn't take away the sins of the world. The Lamb of God takes away the sins of the world, and only He grants us peace. Today, may we think of the words we're going to speak. May we remind God of the deal. Forgive us as we forgive. And so it is pretty straightforward and pretty simple. But it can be a monumental task. But grace makes all things possible. And so I go back to the question, who is the person or persons you are keeping out of your mind right now? Because this message better not apply to you.
you and them. That's where you start. Because the question we have to ask ourselves is the repeated line we sang in the psalm today. The Lord is kind and merciful, full of compassion. Am I?
I believe in one God, Father, Maker of heaven and earth, and all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God of God, light of light, true God of true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made, for us sin and for our salvation.
Praise, O God, Almighty Father, for all you do in this world, for our Lord Jesus Christ. Though the human race is divided by dissension and discord, we know it's you by testing us, change our hearts, and prepare them for reconciliation. Even more, by your spirit, you move human hearts. That enemies may speak to each other again, adversaries join hands, and peoples seek to be together. By the working of your great power comes about, O Lord, that hatred is overcome by love, revenge leads away to forgiveness, and discord is changed to mutual respect. So therefore we give you thanks, the choirs of heaven, and we cry out to your majesty on earth, as without end, we acclaim.
Who hit on with him, I mean?
O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Thank you.
Let us pray. May the working of this heavenly gift, O Lord, we pray, be in possession of our minds and bodies, so that its effects and our own desires be always prevail in us through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thanks again to those who are supporting the Vocation Support Association appeal. If you get to and could, the sheets are in the small vestibule to go out on your right. This is the last invitation as that we'd like to get that wrapped up and begin to move forward. So thank you again to those who recommitted and those who joined to help support our two men in formation who this spring, after 6 years of formation, will be ordained for the priesthood. So we really appreciate that. In the bulletin, you'll see some upcoming things. There's an info night this week on Tuesday for those who are not Catholic who might want to explore our Catholic faith. So the RCIA info session is downstairs in the lower hall. You can pass the word on, invite them, offer to come with them as well. There's some upcoming things that have a little preview of coming attractions in various areas of parish life that are in there. 40 Days for Life coming, and you're invited to be a part of that in varied ways. There's full information for all families and faith formation. There's a page of information and registration forms at the door. And you'll also notice a full page of updates on our repurposing and restoration efforts down the street. I want to thank our parishioner Ginger, who is going over now every few days. The guys treat her with a lot of TLC as they escort her around. She kind of walks through the war zone of lifts and scaffolding and things that are dismantled and smashed, and she captures pictures. So there's some wonderful ones. This week, the majority of time was spent in the preparation of the walls for the new artistic decorative painting, with all of the preparation, the priming, but also a lot of plaster repair, and damage through the years, things that were just patched over. As I said before, we're doing it once, we're doing it right. So there's a lot that's involved. You see in one of the pictures, the stairs that used to lead up to the sanctuary totally demolished, and the rebuilding of the new ones is going to begin this week. So those pictures, they have a little glimpse outside.